This video is going to be about systems of equations, and in this one I want to go over word problems. So let's get started. I've got this problem here. I have 12 coins, a combination of nickels and dimes. The total value of the coins is 85 cents. How many of each coin do I have? So let's write down what I've got. There are 12 coins, and they're nickels and dimes. So I'm just going to put an N and a D. And the total value is, how much did this say? 85 cents. And it asks, how many of each coin do I have? So we're going to say that N and D stand for the number of coins. So N is the number of nickels. These are nickels. And D is the number of dimes. And we know that there's a total of 12 coins. So I can make an equation. I know that the number of nickels plus the number of dimes must equal 12. So I can write N plus D equals 12. And, you know, when you have a system of equations, you need two equations. You need as many equations as you have unknowns, and we have two unknowns, the N and the D. Now, the trick here is to remember that nickels are worth 5 cents and dimes are worth 10 cents. So however many nickels I have, if I multiply that number by 5, I'll get the amount of money that the nickels are worth. So in other words, all of the nickels are going to be worth 5 for 5 cents times the number of nickels. And the dimes are worth 10 cents, so all of the dimes will be worth 10 times D, since dimes are 10 cents. And altogether, I know I have 85 cents. Okay, so now I've got two equations, two unknowns, and I can solve this. I could either solve it with a graph, I could solve it with substitution, or I could solve it with elimination. Okay, I'm going to let you solve it. I just want to do the setup part, since setting up word problems seems to be the hardest part for most people. Okay, let's look at another one. So let's get this there. Okay, I bought 3 candy bars and 2 bags of chips and spent $5.40. My friend bought 2 candy bars and 5 bags of chips and spent $9.10. How much did each item cost? Okay, we're looking for the number of the cost of the candy bars and the cost of the chips. So since candy and chips both begin with a C, let's use X for the cost of the candy, and Y will be the cost of the chips. The variables you use are going to be the things you're looking for. And since I'm looking for how much they cost, my variables will stand for the cost of each item. Okay? Now, let's go back to the question, to the problem. 3 candy bars and 2 bags of chips cost $5.40. So 3 times the cost of the candy bars, 3x would be how much the candy bars cost. And 2 times the cost of the chips, or 2y, would equal 540. My friend bought 2 candy bars, so he paid 2x for his candy bars, 2 times the cost of the candy bars, plus he bought 5 bags of chips. So he spent 5 times the cost of a bag of chips, and he paid $9.10. Okay, so once again, I've got two equations with two unknowns. I've got a system of equations. You can solve this whatever way you think will be most convenient. Let's look at another one. Here we go. The perimeter of a rectangle is 24 feet. The length is 3 times the width. Okay, so let's remember about rectangles. A rectangle is 4 sides, and it's got a length and a length and a width and a width. So the perimeter, let's just say P, equals 2L plus 2W. And it says the perimeter of a rectangle is 24 feet. So I know that 2L plus 2W equals 24. And what else does it say? The length is 3 times the width. So if the length is 3 times the width, that means the length equals, there it is, the length equals 3 times the width. Once again, I have two equations, two unknowns. So I have a system of equations, and it looks like this might be really nice to solve with substitution. Since we know that the L equals 3W, we would just put the 3W there. But again, you can solve this any way you want. The main thing is to get the right answer. Let's look at the next one. Dan invested a total of $12,000. He invested some money at 3% and some at 5%. Okay, let's write down these facts. There were $12,000, and there was 3%. Let's write that as a decimal, 0.03. And there was also 5%, 0.05. And he earned a total, in other words, his interest for both the investments was $460. And we want to know how much he invested at each rate. Okay, so let's call the 3% rate the X rate and the 5% rate the Y rate. And we know that, so X is the amount of money he invested at 3%. It's an amount of money. And Y is the amount of money he invested at 5%. Well, those two amounts totaled up to $12,000. So I can say that X plus Y equals 12,000. Now I need another equation. Well, he earned $460 total. Some of that came from the 3% investment, and some came from the 5% investment. So if we multiply the amount of money he invested at 3% times the percentage, that will tell me what his interest was for that. So 0.03 times the amount of money he invested plus 5% of the amount of money he invested at 5%. So 0.05y. And the two amounts of interest together were $460. Okay, so I've got my two equations, and you can graph them, you can solve them by substitution, you can solve them by elimination, whatever you prefer. So the main thing to remember in these is once you've got them set up, you're doing fine. Whatever the problem is asking you for, like how much did they invest, that's going to be your variables, your X and your Y, or whatever letters you want. And then you want to find the two equations that you can make out of the information you're given. Okay, so I hope this helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.